care to make a guess?
Could you give us a clue?
I'll give you a hint. Look in the back of the nickel.
Come now. Let's have the name of the city water commissioner.
We give up. Who is it?
Why, it's... Isn't that silly? It's right on the tip of my tongue. Just a minute now, I'll think of it.
Amazing. They can't remember you. And I can't forget you.
This is ridiculous. For 14 years, I've been the shining light of City Hall.
Yes, my boy.
You know, they didn't even know who you were on television.
And that's why I came home. I was never so embarrassed in my life. I'll call that editor before he leaves the TV station.
Attaboy, Unc. Tell him off.
No, I'll be diplomatic. Hello? I want to speak with Matthew Walker, the newspaper editor who runs that panel show.
I guess Miss Fuller doesn't think you're so hot now.
Hello? This is Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve, water commissioner.
Who?
No, let's not start that again. I watched your show tonight. Were those people on your panel strangers in town?
What do you mean?
No, Mr. Walker, that's a pretty stupid selection of panelists. Who picked those people?
I did, Gildersleeve. Are you implying I'm stupid because nobody in town knows who the water commissioner is?
Now, see here, old man. You and your newspaper better be careful or I'll cut off your water.
Gildersleeve, you can't talk to me like that.
Hello? Hello? By George, I'll hang up on him. Oh!
Twinkle, twinkle, little Kanish, how I wonder who you wish.
Judge Hook.
Good morning, Gildy.
If you're referring to last night, I told off that editor and I considered the incident closed.
Well, Gildy, he told you off this morning.
He did? Let me see that.
I'll read it for you. Who's who in Summerfield? It should be who isn't who.
All right, Judge. What does it say?
On this newspaper's television quiz last night, not one panelist could name the city water commissioner. This struck your editor as most unusual until he realized he couldn't think of it either. And the fact that so few people know the name of the man who holds such an important position poses this question. Aren't our office holders big enough to command respect and attention?
Give me that paper, Judge.
Temper, temper.
This is serious, Judge. I've always done my job to the best of my ability. I've been proud of the progress my department's made over the years.
Well, Walker didn't mention your name in this article, and no one seems to know it anyway, so what are you worried about?
But I want people to know my name. I want Marjorie and Leroy to be proud of me. Some way I've got to do something to make my name anonymous with water.
Synonymous.
Is synonymous, yeah. What's the difference? All these years of public service and nobody cares. I might as well go and jump in the reservoir.
Well, that's not a bad idea.
What's that?
Well, it's one way to get your name in the paper. Now, you've been worried about those underground springs. Here's your chance to check them yourself firsthand. And while you're doing it, you can get yourself a lot of publicity.
Yeah, I'm not interested in that kind of publicity. But I would like to have those springs inspected.
Well, that's your answer. Inspect them yourself.
But they're underwater.
You can make it with a diving suit.
40 feet?
That's one way for the water commissioner to make a big splash. That's a joke, Gildy. That's one way for the water commissioner to make a big splash.
Hello, Sally.
Hello, Throckmorton.
I hope I didn't disturb you, but I wanted to apologize for the way I behaved last night.
Oh, we didn't notice anything, did we, Uncle Brandon?
Oh, nothing out of the ordinary.
You shouldn't let this quizmaster upset you.
It was a nasty shock.
Oh, you're taking it too seriously. After all, how many people can remember the names of their city officials, or even their congressmen, for that matter?
Well, maybe it's my own fault. Maybe I'm too modest. I guess I've been hiding my light under a bushel basket. What do you think, Mr. Fuller?
I don't think they make a bushel basket large enough.
No. Of course, if I was a publicity hound, I know how I'd get plenty of it.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah, I've been thinking of going to the bottom of the reservoir in a diving suit to inspect the underground springs.
Good heavens, isn't that dangerous?
Yes, it is, but I've never been one to shirk my responsibility just because of a little danger. Oh, I'd do it all right. But where in Summerfield could you find a diving suit?
Gildersleeve. Fortunately, I know where you can get a diving suit.
You do? A diving suit?
Hello there, Mr. Gildersleeve. What can I do for you today?
Oh, my goodness. Let me out of this thing. Peavy, how could you tell it was me?
By the size of your head. What are you up to anyway, Mr. Gildersleeve?
Well, there's an underground spring at the bottom of the reservoir. We're not sure, but we think we may be getting some sludge from it. So I'm going down in this diving suit to check it. What do you think people will say about that?
Well, they'll say we all got to go sometime. But on the level, are you really going to do it?
It's my duty.
Yeah, and it's also a way to get your name in the paper so that newspaper fellow will get off of your back. But it's the hard way, I'll admit that.
That has nothing to do with it. However, after a heroic act of this kind, perhaps the citizens of Summerfield will remember my name.
Well, they will if you ever come up. Where'd you get this suit, Mr. Gildersleeve?
It wore a surplus.
Uh-huh. I wonder why the Navy didn't want it.
Peavy, you aren't suggesting there's something wrong with it, are you?
Well, I'm a cautious man. I'm just asking a question.
Good, Peavy. You do think this is the only decent thing to do?
Well, yes.
So if you were me, you'd go under 40 feet of water, too.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Say, I wonder if this suit wouldn't fit somebody else in the department better than it fits me.
Yeah.
You sound for me, Commissioner?
Whoa, come in, Charlie.
What's on your mind?
The water department has to prove itself. We've got a problem that concerns the public welfare, and I need your help.
What's that?
It was a diving suit. We're going to check the underground springs at the reservoir.
Goodbye, bud.
No, wait a minute, Charlie.
Well, Commissioner, you're not going to put me in no rubber straitjacket and dump me into 40 feet of water.
No, Charlie.
If you want somebody to go down and rub noses with those mud turtles, get yourself another boy.
Okay, Charlie, I'll go down.
Oh? So we'll have to get ourselves another water commissioner.
Me, Mary? The assault come out and be recognized.
See? It really is me.
Good heavens, where are you going in that?
Just gonna test it a little.
How are you gonna get in it all at once?
Yeah, we'll test one part at a time, like you do an inch or two. First that leg. Now the other one.
Well, looks like you're going to have to go in the reservoir, Unc.
No, we haven't tested it all yet. Wait till I sit down in it.
Oh, I'll help you. What a way to take a bath. You don't even get wet.
How am I doing, Leroy?
No bubbles yet.
Darn it. No leaks fore or aft.
I'll be right back, Unc.
All right, Leroy. I'll just sit here for a while. Maybe I've got a slow leak. Yeah, still no leaks.
Leroy, what's going on? Bernie!
Leroy, what do you mean parading those children through my clean house?
I'll split with you, Bertie.
Leroy.
Oops, here comes the man from Mars.
Mr. Gildersleeve, are you really going to the bottom of the reservoir in that outfit?
Well, it could be. This isn't one of my best ideas, Bertie.
Well, what if your left feet get stuck on the bottom?
Get stuck?
Great! We could get a derrick to hoist him. You'd get publicity all over the country.
Now, Leroy.
It'd take a long time to get a derrick out there.
I can just see the headlines now. Water commissioner on bottom for a third day.
Leroy!
To get you out, they may have to dynamite the reservoir.
Poor Mr. Gildersleeve!
That settles it. By George, I'm not going down. I'm no fool.
I'll get it, Bertie.
Hello, Throckmorton.
Why, Sally?
I haven't time to come in, but I hear you have the diving suit and you're going down.
Well, I
think that's wonderfully brave of you. Brandon thought you were afraid.
Well,
I just came to wish you luck. Bye now.
You think he's gone?
He's gone.
Oh, my goodness. Leroy, take that off before you get hurt. Now, be careful. Sammy, watch your nose. Well, my boy, this is D-Day. This is when I go over the top. Or under the bottom.
Listen, Unc. Marge and I have been talking about it, and we just want you to know you don't have to do this for us.
Yeah, that's very nice of you, Leroy, but I'm in too deep already.
Well, if you are going through with it, maybe you better leave us the key to the safety deposit box.
No, Leroy. I've instructed Bertie about that. She'll take care of things.
It's Charlie Anderson's truck.
Oh, isn't he early?
Uh-huh. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go, Unc. It's H hour. I'll help you carry your suit.
You're all right, my boy.
Well, it's a long way to the bottom.
Well, we better check it.
Now?
Right now.
Well, it's time enough to check it out at the reservoir.
We'll double check it out there. You know how it works?
Sure, you just attach the hose to the nozzle on the helmet. Here, put it on.
Hey, wait a minute.
There. I'll get this gadget working.
You're in no hurry, Charlie.
Leroy, give me a hand here, will you?
Okay.
Leroy!
1 minute, Unc. I'm helping Mr. Anderson.
Yeah. I want you to pull the newspaper for me. It's important.
Thanks, Leroy.
You're welcome. Yes, Unc?
Yes, come here, boy.
This'll take just a minute, Commissioner.
There's really no rush at all, Charlie.
There. Now this goes in back here.
No, back? All right.
Is this the Summerfield Clarion? Good. I want to report a man doing a crazy thing. Yeah, he's going to jump in the reservoir. So send a photographer. He's going down in a war surplus diving suit. That's all he told me to tell you. But it's a big story, so be sure you have someone there to cover it. Bye.
All right, test number one. Ready?
Ready.
Okay, air pressure coming up. Roger, we'll come out. Ready?
Let her go, Tony.
Now,
Where's the photographer?
They said he'd be here, Unc.
I'm going to test this motor again, Commissioner. Of course, I doubt if it'll keep running until we get you back up.
Charlie!
Well, hello there, Mr. Gildersleeve. Leroy?
Hi.
Peavy, what are you doing here?
Well, I've seen balloons go up. Now I want to see one go down.
This motor seems to have a knock in it, Commissioner.
Well, it could be Mr. Gildersleeve's knees.
Hey, Unc, I hear a car. Maybe it's the guy with the camera.
Yeah, good, my boy. Come on, Charlie. Let's get going. Excuse me, Mr.
Peavy. Confidentially, Charlie, I don't have to go way down. Just a couple feet below the surface will do.
I want no part of subterfuge, Commissioner. If you think I'm going to help you flim-flam the public, get yourself another boy.
Charlie, watch it!
Good gracious. Awful lot of gadgets.
Okay.
Daredevil.
He's on a very important mission.
There she blows!
Hey, does the water commissioner know about this?
He'll get to the bottom of it pretty soon.
Hey, deeper than I thought. I'd better make contact.
Whoa, Belly.
You think he's okay, Mr. Anderson?
Oh, excuse me. Well, he's still making bubbles.
Oh, let's see. Oh. Hello, long distance. Give me the briny D. Are you there, Commissioner?
Am I here?
Charlie, he blew me up.
Well, you just got down there. Leroy, want to talk to your uncle?
Sure. Hi, Unc.
Leroy, instruct Charlie to pull me up.
Mr. Peavy, say hello to the Commissioner.
Well, hello there, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Peavy, get off the line.
Very well.
Get away, fish.
Commissioner, you see anything in those underground springs?
Charlie!
Well, then, down you go.
Confounded Charlie. How do I get into these things? No, Charlie. Pull me up.
Here he comes.
Hey, you look a little green, Commissioner.
You would be, too, if you'd swallowed a cigar. Well, there's no sludge in the springs. I saw that for myself. Where's the photographer, Leroy?
He took your picture and left.
It'll be in the paper, all right.
Good. Well, get me out of this thing.
I think it's just wonderful.
And I do, too. Anytime a man will put on a diving suit and go down in 40 feet of water, I think it's just wonderful.
Yeah, thank you,
anytime a man will put on a diving suit and go down in 40 feet of water,
I know, Bertie.
I think it's just wonderful.
Bertie! Come to think of it, not many men would go down in 40 feet of water in a strange diving suit.
Did you really go all the way to the bottom?
You bet. Some people might try to flim-flam the public and only get on a couple of feet. But I want no part of subterfuge.
I'm proud of you, Throckmorton.
And me too, Mr. Gildersleeve. Yeah,
thank you, Bertie.
And so am I.
Of course, I'm no publicity hound. But one thing's sure. When that paper hits the streets, everyone is going to know that Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve is the water commissioner. I may just make a modest statement assuring the citizens of Summerfield that the water system remains pure and safe. You know, something simple and dignified.
Well, here it is, Unc. You made the front page.
Well, news is news.
They printed your picture and everything.
By George, when I go after publicity, I get it.
Is that you?
Read it out loud, Charlie.
Well, it says, unidentified diver cavorts in reservoir.
What's that?
Well, there's more.
Where was Summerfield's water commissioner when these shenanigans took place?
Let me see that.